Welcome to part two of the plumbing. I am going to go into a little bit more detail of how this whole system works, why we are running, what we are running, why we are running 1-inch tube, and then 1/2-inch tubes with mini blocks, and then also how the pressing itself works of these connections.
Just under a year into the process of renovating our 1903 Victorian home, the TirolerInn. Join us as we customize this home to our vision of ideal living and also strive to maintain the unique charm and character of times long past.
So this is the setup for the laundry room and the shared kids bathroom. We're gonna have a double sink, double vanity. So two on each side, cold and hot. And for the shower here, and then for the toilet. There will be one more thing that I'm gonna add is a tub. I don't have the fitting right now. We need a T-fitting here and here, one more, and that's going to be for the tub. The tub, we're gonna do 3/4 inch instead of 1/2 inch, so we get a little bit of extra faster flow to fill the tub up. And then down here, we have the washing machine, hot and cold, and you can see I'm still missing a valve here too. Put a system in like this with the different branches, and it's kind of a hybrid system. It's normally either most people that do a PEX system nowadays do a home run system, where you have in the basement or wherever you have your utility room, you would have one manifold that then kind of has 1/2-inch PEX tubing that goes to each faucet, or sometimes 3/4-inch, for example, for a tub. I chose not to do that because you have a lot of water loss, because it has to evacuate the entire tube. Of course, it's a much smaller tube than a big trunk that you would normally have, but you have to evacuate that entire tube. And then there's kind of the other option of having one big long trunk, 1-inch tube, 1-inch trunk in the system, in the house, and then branch from there. And we are kind of doing a hybrid system. Instead of just having a trunk, we're the old style trunk system was also where you kind of had one trunk and you had to evacuate that entire trunk before you got hot water because they didn't have a recirculation pump. So we are doing a recirculation pump that has that one inch tube throughout the entire house that then basically just continuously pumps the hot water when needed around in that circle. So water is hot up until the point where it branches off. And then I'm putting these mini blocks in convenient areas close by in the different areas where we need, where we have a bathroom or a kitchen where we need water. And then I just do the final run as a branch system. And I'm doing it with the PEX system also here with only a half inch tube. So the longest run that I have calculated here is going from the laundry room slash bathroom manifold here and then going over to the shower in that bathroom. It's a 20 foot run and calculated volume. I can evacuate that 20 foot run within 5 to 6 seconds. So the shower would have to be on for 5 to 6 seconds before we would have hot water at the shower. Everything else, like you can see here, where I am from this block, from this mini block to over here, where we're gonna have a faucet. This is only 3 feet, so we would have less than a second until this whole tube is evacuated. So basically, by the time you turn on the faucet and put your hands underneath it, you'll already have a second and you have instant hot water right there at that faucet. And then the same thing at the next one. And the tub, which is going underneath here, since it's a thicker line, has to evacuate more, but it also runs faster. So it would take somewhere in the 3 to 4 seconds until the tub gets hot water too. If you enjoy these type of videos, make sure to subscribe and click the little bell button so you get a notification when the next video comes out. We'll be right back. I'm a big fan of this VIEGA PEX press system. It's really easy to connect everything and also makes it pretty simple to run long continuous runs. I have a lot less pressure loss the way we're doing it with a big 1-inch circulation line that goes through the entire house. So it continuously runs the pump and has hot water in the tube, in this tube here. We will have insulation on here still. And then you can see we're using some of those mini blocks to branch off from there to all our different faucets. And I'm in each one of the areas that I'm doing with the two bathrooms. I have a section where an access panel is gonna be in the wall, just like here. We're gonna cover this so that we can isolate a line. If something is broken, I can just isolate this one line instead of just at the end where the faucet would normally be, and there's always that little valve at the end. But what happens if I need to replace that valve over there that is broken? So now here I can just turn this off and replace a valve in the future.
So here you can see there's these tiny holes here, and every time we go to crimp this down on the pipe, we just double check that the pipe is all the way in, and that you can see a little bit of the blue or red, depending on which one, through the holes. Yeah.
up here in the attic, I added the recirculation loop. I just pushed it up into the attic so that I have it ready for the future when we want to expand into the attic. So basically, the hot water is going to come in here. I leave this valve open. It's going to go back right down into the loop. And then when I'm ready to extend the loop to whatever bathroom up here, I'm just going to extend one more tube here, one tube here, and run it wherever I need to run it. Then I would close this and open those two. I would close the flow again through here, through the tube, and then out of here. Since we're already up here in the attic, I'm standing here in the corner where behind me is the water that I just finished. And you can see I have 16 20-foot ceilings up here. And then there is an enclosed area of two rooms right now. When you come up the staircase, we have one room over here with one window and another window with the beautiful views again. And then if I go down this hallway, we have another room that is pretty small and closed. So what's going to happen here is we will take all that shiplap off on the walls everywhere, open it all up, and then we decide of kind of how we want to lay out this attic. We'll probably put a bathroom, a big master closet, a master bedroom, of course, and then maybe a small little office up here too. Missing a few more valves, I think 5 or 6 half-inch valves, so that I can finish. And I'm a little short on some of the half-inch tubing also. I think I need another stick of glue just so I can finish this bathroom. And then of course the kitchen, I haven't plumbed at all because we are not exactly sure where all the sinks and everything's gonna be. But otherwise, we had a good week, and I hope to see you next week. We'll probably finish up the water heater section and get all that loop continued, and then I think we'll be done for hot water for a while. I will probably run some of the wastewater piping and then also the electrical here in the next few videos. thanks. See you next week. Bye.